What would the world look like if we drained all the water? About 71% of the Earth's surface is water covered, and the oceans hold about 96.5% of all of the Earth's water. Water is in the air, our body is made up of it, on average 60% water, and it's essential for anything living, humans, animals, plants, to have water. But what would happen if we drained the Earth of its water? More specifically, what would the Earth look like if we drained all the water? We're going to answer that here for you on Life's Biggest Questions. What's going on, everyone? I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and welcome back to another episode of Life's Biggest Questions. Today, we'll be taking a look at what the world would look like if we drained all the water. Now, as always, drop us a comment down below with a question you'd love the answer to. Be sure to subscribe so you guys never miss a video. And as always, I'll be responding to some comments at the end of this one, but let's get into it. As previously mentioned at the beginning of this video, almost 3/4 of the Earth's surface is made up of water. It controls the weather, gives life not only to us, but animals both above and underwater. And we even use it to clean ourselves. It's clearly a necessity for living. But in a world where water was completely drained, none of this would be possible. Aside from the inevitable death of literally anything living, including the human race, the Earth itself would of course look very different. Given that the oceans hold almost all of the world's water, well, you can imagine how much more land there would be. To give you an idea, the biggest ocean in the world is the Pacific Ocean, and it covers almost half of the Earth's total water. If we drained that ocean alone, we would see approximately 168,723,000 square kilometers of land that was once submerged in the ocean. It's equivalent to over 41.5 billion acres, or over 40 billion football fields from end zone to end zone. And that's just the Pacific Ocean we're talking about. If we drained all the oceans, we'd have more than double that of new land that was once submerged underwater. Now, it's important for you guys to keep in mind, this doesn't include lakes, rivers, seas, and bays. So if you were to drain all the water in the world, well, you'd obviously see a lot more land. It would also lead to all the grass dying, meaning you'd be mostly left with sand or dirt. In fact, as previously mentioned, any living organism would die. No trees, no animals, no humans. But how could a lack of water affect the weather? Well, there wouldn't be any clouds and it wouldn't rain. When water is heated at the equator, it evaporates and turns into what we know as clouds. The evaporated water is also what puts moisture in the air, and with the sun constantly beaming down on the Earth, well, it would make the Earth's temperature much, much hotter. Eventually, the Earth's oxygen would dissipate, and it's more likely than not that wildfires would burn down any remaining dried out trees. In short, the Earth would turn into a massive desert, and the only organism that would be able to survive, maybe some sort of bacteria. All other forms of life would die, there would be a ton of more land, of course, than before, and the Earth would see a massive increase in both the core's temperature and the surface temperature. Safe to say, no one would be able to really live here. And on that note, I think it'd be nice to reply to some comments, because, you know, I like the Earth and living, so let's cheer up. In the video we did titled What Happened to the Holy Grail, Avery the Cuban American said, according to The Last Crusade, Indiana Jones lost the Grail. Well, someone get Harrison back on the phone because he's got to find it. Tishy Goldie said, I want to know who was the person that woke up one day and thought, I wonder what happened to the Holy Grail. It's actually a great question. After it was last seen, why didn't anybody think, I'm going to put this away? They just kind of ate and then just left it at the table, and then, you know, thousands of years later, hundreds of thousands of years later, like, you know, we're kind of just like, where is it? I don't even know how many years ago that was. I probably should. Anyways, next comment. Matt Truck said, why is there light on Earth but none in space? Well, I don't have an answer right now, but it is Friday and probably just spent my whole weekend looking for an answer. So thanks for that. Anyways, guys, that does it for this video. Once again, I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. Be sure to drop us a comment down below with your thoughts on this video. And if you're lucky, it'll be featured in our next video. Thanks for tuning in again to Life's Biggest Questions. Be sure to subscribe so you guys don't miss a video where we might respond to your question. And of course, we'll see you in the next one.